I'm Dr. Anjali Hooda Sangwan, an American Board Certified Obesity, Metabolic Medicine and Clinical Nutrition Consultant.
Surya Namaskar or the Sun Salutation is proven to be a highly effective exercise for those with diabetes and PCOS and is considered to be a complete body exercise. Doing this for 15 minutes every morning can make a huge difference in increasing the metabolism rate of the body.
Just remember that doing these poses, the accuracy will take time and you don't have to hurry this up. Just take it easy. Start small but be persistent. So sun salutation is one of the most beneficial form of yoga poses and easy to attain. Just be a little more careful when you do it. Go slow.
Okay, so you have to repeat around 5 times.
So we now have the butterfly pose.
For that we have to sit and then we have to join like this.
For butterfly pose, you must make sure that your feet are together and you bring them as close to your pelvis as possible. And then you're moving your knees like a butterfly, like a fluttering of a butterfly.
Butterfly pose, which is also known as the Baddha Konasana. This works wonderfully for natural PCOS treatment. This asana helps to open up the pelvic region and promote relaxation, which in turn helps to reduce stress and relieve discomfort related to menstruation. In addition, it is an also amazing healing yoga pose for people with back problems.
So next we are going for boat pose.
Boat pose is also called in Hindi as Nauka Asana, and like how Twinkle is showing us, so it's like being in a boat.
The boat pose, like it is also known as Naukasana, is one of the useful yoga asanas for PCOS treatment that is also beneficial for weight loss as well. It is the best type of yoga for weight loss as it helps to achieve a perfectly flat abdomen. It puts controlled pressure on the abdominal region, increases blood flow to the reproductive organs and enhances the functions of the ovaries. Like you can see that there's a lot of pressure put on the abdominal region, hence it is perfect for to obtain a flat abdomen.
Next we are going for go pose.
The bow pose, also known as Dhanurasana, is another functional posture that is used for polycystic ovarian syndrome treating using yoga. It stimulates the functions of the reproductive organs, relieves menstrual discomfort and normalizes the menstrual cycles. It also helps people with kidney disorders open up the chest, neck and shoulders and strengthen the core muscles.
We can do it one more time, how you started. Just one more time so we can tell.
So you have to lie down at the
okay.
front.
Okay.
Okay.
So everybody may not be able to achieve the kind of flexibility that Twinkle has, but you can always start from a. Okay. Let me try. So I'm not that flexible.
It's training, but I'm not flexible. I'm gonna try this. I can do it. So we do this.
Along with PCOS, the bow pose is also beneficial for diabetes. It improves the functioning of pancreas and intestines, thus helps in controlling blood sugar levels. Organs like liver, pancreas and enzyme producing organs will function actively by practicing this asana.
Next we are having Superman
pose. Wow.
The Superman pose. This is essential yoga pose for PCOS infertility treatment that looks almost like the signature move of the Superman. This specific yoga pose works as good as belly breathing exercise for developing a toned abdomen. It also helps to promote blood circulation to the reproductive organs, tones the abdomen and lower back muscles, strengthens the chest, shoulder, arms and legs, and opens the chest.
This one looks very difficult. How difficult is it for a normal person, Twinkle? This looks very difficult, right? Okay, just do it one more time. Let's restart. Let's just see it again, because it looks really difficult to me. So, you know, you need to make sure that you are in consultation with your... Yeah, you should be flexible for this, because... Okay, so it's like you make sort of a bridge. Okay. Oh, can you do this instead of that? You can do a bridge instead of that pose?
To start with?
You can do a bridge, and then... What's the advanced way? Okay. Benefits are the same. So you can do a bridge, and instead of the bow, what is it called? Superman.
Superman
pose. It is a Superman pose. Okay. So we can do child pose.
The Balasana.
Yeah, the child pose. Child pose is also very beneficial for the pelvis area. And it really gives you a good stretch on your back and your glutes, gluteal region. So basically your hips should be touching your heels in this. And you can, most of the poses I think you need to hold, I'm not sure, but 10 seconds at least?
Yes.
Yeah, 10 seconds at least. Yeah, child pose is easy. You can see, it's like you can remember it like children sitting.
Okay. Child pose, also known as the Balasana, it is one of the vital yoga poses included in PCOS natural treatment that brings relaxation by soothing the central nervous system. It also releases lower back tension, menstrual cramps and PMS symptoms, and normalizes blood flow throughout the body.
Wow, that looks really good. Okay, then we can do the cobra.
Cobra is so good.
Yeah. Yes,
you can pull up the cobra and explain about the cobra.
The cobra pose, which is also known as the Bhujangasana, is yet another easy and simple yoga asana that holds an important place in PCOS yoga treatment, and women of all ages can practice it right from PCOS diagnosis in order to control the symptoms naturally. This posture exerts soothing pressure on the stomach and aids to stimulate the functions of the ovary. It also helps in better digestion and reduces stress. But it's best not to hold this posture for more than 30 seconds at a time. So you stay at the posture, hold it for 30 seconds and then come back. Relax and do it again for 30 seconds.
Next is the